Guys, welcome back into NFL offseason rumors on this fine Saturday early afternoon. Wanted to get to some Baker Mayfield trade update stuff. It says Ian Rapoport is reporting he expects the Browns to trade Baker Mayfield before the NFL draft, and the Browns are getting desperate with Baker. At this point, they are, it looks like, willing to cover some of his $18 million salary that he is due. The Browns have, you know, accepted that 50-year option. He is a former number one overall pick, so the 50-year option is worth $18 million, and teams just simply don't want to pay it. They have a bad cap situation, whatever. But at this point, guys, the Browns just want to avoid having to outright release him. That is not an option because they don't want him to go sign with a rival team in division like the Pittsburgh Steelers, who need quarterback help. I guess you could say they do have Mitch Trubisky, but still, the Steelers would be a team where the Browns, if they released him, they would be a team that would be very interested. So the Browns trying to keep that from happening. And it says in this update, the Seattle Seahawks are the favorites for Baker Mayfield. We'll see what they do with DK Metcalf. Do they trade him? Do they give him a massive extension? He needs a new contract after next offseason. So he's got one more year left before they have to extend him. The Seahawks are the favorite. And then it also lists the Titans and the Bucks. Not too sure about, I mean, maybe the Titans don't love Ryan Tannehill. They want him as a backup. The Bucks, it would be most assuredly a backup route for Baker. I don't think that's what Baker wants. I think he wants to start. He wants to, you know, prove himself. His agent is probably looking for a starting chance. Right now, it seems like by far the best position for Baker Mayfield to start next year and be put in a position to potentially succeed would be with the Seattle Seahawks with their wide receivers. They still need offensive line help, but at this point, the Browns' thought process is, let's just trade him. If we can get a fourth or a fifth round pick, that's great. Let's send him somewhere into the NFC, preferably. Worst case, we're not cutting him, we're not releasing him, so we don't want to allow him to sign with, you know, any team, possibly the Steelers. That's what they're trying to not have happen. I think they'll end up trading him to a team like the Seahawks, probably eat half of his salary, so I have to pay him $9 million. The Seahawks will take on the other $9 million, and the Seahawks will give the Browns a fourth or a fifth round pick. At this point, that's where it's trending. That's the update on Baker Mayfield, but the Browns do want to get him traded before the NFL draft. Xavien Howard. Did you guys see this? Dolphins signed Xavien Howard 5 years, $90 million extension. Howard had 3 years remaining on a 5-year, $75 million contract signed in 2019. His new deal tax on 2 years and another $50 million. Am I wrong for thinking this is a terrible deal by the Dolphins? You still had Xavien Howard for 3 more prime years. You're adding 2 more years onto his deal and giving him $50 million more dollars as a cornerback? It's not like this dude's a QB. This is a cornerback. So they extended him 2 more years. He already had 3 years remaining on his contract. He's a good corner. Don't get me wrong. But we've seen it with these cornerbacks. They become washed really quickly. Patrick Peterson, 2-3 years. He's completely washed. Darrell Revis got washed really quickly after winning a Super Bowl with the Patriots in 2014. It looked like the Dolphins were in a great situation to get Xavien Howard's prime years. And then as he's tailing off, possibly just letting him go. They're adding 2 more years and paying him $50 million more dollars. I do not think this is a good deal for the Miami Dolphins at all. There was no reason to do this. He's coming off a great year. I understand that. But we're talking about 4 or 5 years down the line. I think that's a very questionable move by the Dolphins. Xavien Howard's a really good corner, but that is a lot to tack on. So you're tacking on 2 more years for $50 million. You didn't have to extend him at all. You still had him under contract for 3 years. So that is an interesting move there, if I'm reading that correctly. Also, get a load of this one. Colin Kaepernick will hold an exhibition throwing event with some draft eligible players tomorrow during halftime of Michigan's spring game. So Colin Kaepernick has been visiting Michigan because Jim Harbaugh is there, the connection. Just a really weird situation. And it looks like he will hold yet another event for NFL teams to come out and watch him. I don't expect anyone to sign Colin Kaepernick at all at this point. He is 34 years old. Saw this thing this morning on Austin Eckler, and it's a little concerning. Austin Eckler said he advocates for limiting his touches to remain healthy during the NFL season. So if you're a fantasy football player, fantasy football fan out there, this is a really interesting development with Austin Eckler, and you're going to want to mark this down because Austin Eckler is a guy, especially in PPR leagues, goes very high, mid-first round. He himself is advocating for limiting his own touches because he keeps getting injured. So interesting thing to watch. We all love fantasy football, though I think fantasy football has been a little bit hijacked by these dynasty leagues. It's annoying. I think you should do redraft, but it is what it is. But Austin Eckler, guys, very interesting that he himself is advocating for cutting back his workload because he's been injured the past few years. Breece Hall, I'm part of the Breece Hall fan club. We've got ESPN's Matt Miller believing that Breece Hall possibly will be picked late in the first round, maybe to a team like the Buccaneers. Don't really love that fit with the Buccaneers re-signing Leonard Fournette. I think if you're going to invest a first-round pick into a running back, especially in this day and age, he needs to be your starting running back. He needs to get 20 touches a game. You know, a first-round pick into a running back is rare. I love the fit with the Buffalo Bills for Breece Hall. Tell Zach Moss you're a good little player, but you're not good enough. Adios. Devin Singletary, not good enough. Get Breece Hall, get Josh Allen, a legit RB1. Breece Hall's a beast. He's the clear running back one in this draft. I think most experts are now, they've pivoted their talking points. Breece Hall is RB1, Kenneth Walker is RB2, and Breece Hall has a legitimate chance to go towards the back half of the first round, and my landing spot for him would be the Buffalo Bills. The Buccaneers, they just, if they wouldn't have re-signed Fournette, I would say, yeah, that's a legit landing spot with Tom Brady there. He wants a running back at his age. But at this point, with them re-signing Leonard Fournette, giving him money, making that commitment, if you're going to invest a first-round pick on a running back, you're going to want him to get touched the ball 20 times his rookie year, right? You're going to want him to touch the ball. So Breece Hall, possible fit there would be the Buffalo Bills with Josh Allen. And that would really be the first time Josh Allen's had a legitimate running back. He's been dealing with Zach Moss, Singletary, his first few years in the NFL. An update on Gronk. We've got CBS Sports expecting Rob Gronkowski to re-sign with the Buccaneers. Once Tom Brady announced he was coming back to the Bucs, everyone knew this was a formality. It's going to happen. He's going to re-sign and be with Brady. Would have been interesting if Tom Brady stayed retired. There were a few rumors floating out there of Gronk potentially going to Buffalo with Josh Allen. That would have been interesting, but at this point, it would be a shock to everyone if Gronk was not back with the Buccaneers, probably his last year in the NFL, or maybe if Brady wants to continue playing, he'll continue playing, but he still is a legit good red zone target. Antonio Brown tells TMZ Sports that he will not have ankle surgery unless a team commits to signing him. So Antonio Brown, it's a really weird situation. He still is a good receiver. I mean, he was putting up good numbers with the Buccaneers last year. But is Antonio Brown at this point really worth it? Like, I love receivers and things like that. But at this point, I'm a Browns fan. I would not want the Browns to touch Antonio Brown. And you can say, well, is he a cancer? People overreact. It's too much, man. It's just too much at this point with Antonio Brown. He still legitimately is a good receiver. It's not like he's washed or anything. Like, he can go out and give you 1,100 or 1,200 yards. He is still talented. It's not like he's completely done. But it's just like, is it worth it, man? And personally, for me, it would not be worth it. Like, if the Browns signed Antonio Brown, I would just be like, oh, it's just a circus. It's a circus not worth dealing with. And just one final update on what the Panthers are going to do during the draft with the 6th overall pick. Their GM comes out and says, you hate to force it, but at some point you have to take a shot when discussing the team's number 6th overall pick. I believe the Panthers are in position right now to draft Malik Willis with the number 6th overall pick. I am not a fan of Kenny Pickett. I just watched more film of Kenny Pickett against Clemson. Kenny Pickett has zero elite attributes. Zero. Not a fan of him at all. If you're going to go quarterback at number 6 overall, I believe they will pick the Liberty quarterback, Malik Willis, not Kenny Pickett. I actually have Kenny Pickett as my 5th best quarterback in this draft, maybe even my 6th best. Not a fan of Kenny Pickett. When I watch these college quarterbacks, I'm looking for elite traits that translate to the NFL. And Kenny Pickett does everything decent, but he doesn't do anything great. So I think Kenny Pickett, if you draft him 6th overall, that will be a major, major mistake if you are the Panthers. I do believe they will be taking Malik Willis, but we will see. I certainly think at this point, the Panthers are heavily trending towards drafting a quarterback at number 6 overall. When you just look at them not being interested in Baker Mayfield, not trading for Deshaun Watson. They tried to, but not being able to trade for Deshaun Watson. It looks like your only other option is what? Sam Darnold? I mean, there's no quarterbacks left. Mariota's already signed. Jameis Winston has already re-signed. It is trending heavily towards them drafting the first quarterback of the draft with the number 6 overall pick. And that's what it's looking like, what Carolina is going to be doing. Guys, that's going to do it for this video. Make sure you're following me on Twitter. Link to that's always in the description. I'm, of course, the Depressed Ginger. Thank you for watching.